Just a moment ago was Rocky Lockridge stopping Dennis Cruz, 105, round number 7. Let's go to the ring. Here's the fight doctor.
Rocky, it seemed to me that you were punching in half speed, just bipping and bopping along. Now, what finally woke you up were those two crunching right hands?
You might call it half speed, Ferdy, but the idea of it all was to lure him in. You know, he wasn't supposed to be a runner. He was supposed to stay right there with me. But what I was doing was luring him in and hope that he would drop his hands, in which he did, and catch him off guard.
Well, you certainly did that. Was it surprising to you that you could pin him on the ropes as easily as you did? His whole fight went out the window as soon as you could pin him to the ropes.
Absolutely. I figured that that was more or less his game plan, was to keep me right there with him one way or the other, whether he'd be backing up or whether he'd be coming to me. And what he did wrong was to let me come to him and capture him on the ropes. And like my pity patting, which you obviously seen, lured him into a big shot.
Well, no question about that. The two shots, there were two right hands seen on replay, were devastating punches, as we've seen you punch in the past. But if they had gone on 10 rounds like that, it would have been the stinker of the year, because you just, neither one of you, he wasn't punching hard either.
I couldn't agree with you more, Ferdy, but I realized that he was slowing down considerably. And ultimately speaking, I knew that it would eventually end the way it did, because and at the pace that he was slowing down, he was definitely obligated to walking into something sooner or later.
This obviously thrusts you right back where you belong, or right back where most people think you belong, which is the title picture. You have Chavez, who we already fought and lost, and you have the other two gentlemen waiting for you in the wings. Which would you rather fight?
Well, Ferdy, as hard as I'm working, it actually doesn't matter. I'd like to get back at Chavez and prove myself, prove to the world that I am the junior lightweight king. And If it works out the way we anticipate, either Chavez or the IBF champion has to give up some ground.
Did you expect that Cruz, who's known to punch very hard, would not unleash anything strong at you? I mean, the two or three punches that he threw at you missed by a mile that were strong. The rest were very weak punches. Did that surprise you?
Very much so. Ferdy, I tell you, I was expecting him to shoot his load. And unfortunately, he didn't, or might I say fortunately, he didn't for his part. But later on, like you saw me doing, I was tattooing, touching, and luring him in into a big shot.
And you got the big shot and the win, and congratulations.
Ferdy, can I say one thing?
One quick thing.
Ferdy, I'd like to say, realize your full potential, kids. If you want to be an athlete, give it all you got, and realize that to be a champion, you got to live a clean life.
Thank you very much.
Say no to drugs.
Thank you very much. And back to Marv Albert at ringside.
All right, Ferdy, and coming up, a look at last week's